I always talk to you when it's really cold. I think the last time you used the term boobsicles.
Oh, yes, yeah, boobsicles. Yeah. I've got boobsicles right now.
Boobsicles. So how are the boobsicles? They look really nice.
They're good. They're covered up now, so they're feeling a little bit better.
Choose Peter.
Again, neither.
Oh. Is this your first time in Cannes?
It is.
Or what's been a highlight?
This. Yes. This interview.
This interview right now.
This interview is the best thing I've done in Canada.
You always know the right things to say to someone.
I know.
It's very, very nice. You're
I know how
operator.
To get good press.
It's like American Idol if they had to fight to the death.
My gosh, I know. I'm very good about fumbling on lines. I fumbled on all of my lines because as he was talking, I was just like, he's so pretty. It's like a moth going towards light.
Good morning.
Can you do your an Effie impression?
No.
Do you
have
one?
Another question.
No.
Do you have one?
I can't do it.
No.
Okay. I'll do it.
Okay. Just a little bit over the edge.
Do you have any personal superstitions?
I do something where I state what I don't want. Like I'll say oh, if my plane doesn't crash, because what are the chances of the plane crashing after I say something like that? Or I'm definitely gonna break my ankle running down this hill. Things like that. Is that superstition or is that just stupid?
Oh, okay. I think that counts.
I don't normally read my lines the day before, and then for some reason I got into bed and I was like, why not? Just see what scene we're doing tomorrow. And then I saw that it was the two-page monologue day, and I was like, oh my God. And so I had to try to memorize it, and I thought that sports teams were interchangeable. So I was just like, well, we'll worry about that later. And then I was saying that a football team beat a baseball team and was just talking nonsense. I'm wearing Calvin Klein collection and Jimmy Choo's. And my pedicure is totally messed up. Don't zoom in on it.
We were there at the Golden Globes. Have you heard from Meryl Streep?
Oh my God.
Have you heard from her at all?
No. No. Uh-oh. No, well, I haven't.
But everybody knew. It was kind of an homage.
Well, yeah, but it's also Meryl Streep. Yeah. It's it's like saying something about Jesus. It's what can you say?
Zoe and I are still best friends. We were trying to talk about what do we tell people that we do? Because the truth is, we're sitting on the couch, what do you want to do? I don't know, what do you want to do? And we both knit, so we both tried to knit. So we're Zoe and I knit together.
I really loved the movies. I wasn't aware of them until the audition, and then I watched all of them, and I was oh my God, these movies are awesome.
Couch. Party or couch?
Oh, couch.
Couch party.
This is the bestest party
ever. How much training went into the dancing aspects in the film?
Great I had about double Bradley's. I had extra homework because I'm an extra bad dancer.
Action, as they say in the movies.
The mahogany line was funny.
said, you have to do it.
Maybe you have to give her a little...
I really
show
can't.
Her.
It's mahogany. No, you
so
went.
Good. No, you're doing it wrong.
I need a drink.
Because you are going from shooting squirrels and skinning them to playing Mystique. I mean, you couldn't be further apart from your next role.
Yeah, I kind of like that though. I'm a big kind of polar opposite person. I've always been slightly schizophrenic, so I always kind of expected it to show in my work, and it has. Love the movies, the directors that come out of Cannes. And my experience has been rainy, unfortunately, but it's really lovely. Everybody's very nice, and the traffic is pretty intense. Made me feel right at home, like I was back in LA.
Bob De Niro, I ignored for the first few days because I was afraid to talk to him, but then he was too nice, so I couldn't stay away. And
now you must have gotten in tremendous shape with this film. What has been your workout regimen?
For the film?
Yeah.
Okay. I was talking about today. I was I ate french fries and laid in bed until 3.
You guys have worked too much together, I think.
Yes.
I feel like it's time for a break, don't you?
Yeah.
It's too much already?
Yeah.
Oh, God, they haven't even come out yet.
Yeah, I know. You got a lot of this to do.
Yeah. Is it too much for you?
No, I'm enjoying it.
This is the first one we've ever done together.
Yeah, that's the first time we've heard this.
No.
We had this restaurant that was our favorite restaurant because the people there hated us and they were really, really rude, and we called it the enemies. We just kept wanting to go there because we felt like they hated it every time we went there, so we liked to go there to be like, oh, we're back.
The things that my friends and family have said is the most me moment are the times that I'm running up behind them going, hey! Apparently that's a very familiar noise when you're around me. Hey! So I think that's probably the that's what I've heard the most, that was me.
There was one story about you and the hotel minibar. You said something about it used to be where you couldn't go to the hotel minibar, but now...
Oh, thank God, that's the story. I was like, what? Anytime there's a story about me, a hotel, and a bar, I'm scared.
Yeah, I had about 2 hours of training a day, and I was on a high-protein diet and things like that. But I still didn't end up doing any of my stunts. I thought I was so ready. I thought they were making a warrior or something. I was like, yeah, I'm ready. And they're like, no, you're not doing any of your stunts.
I mean, playing the sex addict. I mean, how does one sort of prepare to play a sex addict?
I'm not method.
TV.
I mean, I love books, but let's be real.
Josh pranked me horribly. One of the characters dies in a very gruesome way, and he took the dummy of it and put it in my bathroom, sitting on the toilet, shut the door. So when I go into my trailer and I open the door, I was in full-blown hysterics. My friend had to like grab me and go, it's fake, it's fake, it's fake. I was like, what is it? It was awful. It was also holding toilet paper, which was a detail I didn't catch till later. That is mahogany!
That's good. That sounded just good. Like her.
That was pretty good.
Right?
Yeah.
You just have to get really guttural in the back of the throat.
Yes.
Almost German.
Mahogany.
Almost German with it.
But you just got dancing lessons for this film, or
yeah? Yeah, but did it look like I even had dancing lessons? I mean, kind of looked like they just electrocuted me and like sent me out there.
Dancing was a lot more fun because that was the easiest, best way to get close with somebody and get the chemistry that we had. It wouldn't have been possible. I mean, we were like, hey, how are you? And then like sweating and his face is in my crotch. Like try to get closer to an actor.
What was it like having to learn this dance? And
Humiliating, mortifying, and fun. It was terrible because Bradley's really good and I'm really bad. So I felt terrible for him because he would like learn it right away. And then I'd be like, I'm gonna need a week and a half. Then I'll get back to you.
Lucas Till played Angry Birds like it was his job. There was this little green room that they tried to make soundproof because we were all so loud, but when we would all shoot together, we would just kind of hang out and be loud. And then Lucas was always in the corner doing Angry Birds, and then he'd like look up every once in a while and be like, oh, that's funny, and then get back to Angry Birds.
He cries every time he hears Call Me Maybe.
What's that?
Call me maybe.
Oh, right. Yeah. I still don't know. Sorry.
He's been in outer space.
Have you been treated any differently on set? Are people now referring to you as Oscar winner Jennifer Lawrence?
Yeah, because I make them. Definitely nobody at work treats me differently. I wish they would. Everybody's, you know, mean as usual.
Who's mean?
No, nobody. Nobody's mean.
just Liam Hemsworth.
Yeah,
just a
Liam
bit.
Is the meanest person I've ever met.
Charlie Sheen all the way. He's a madman.
I don't know either about that. I don't know. I've been reading. I don't know. It's funny.
I've been reading too many books.
I've been reading too many books.
Jennifer, you're very funny. That's a very funny comment.
Thanks, Josh.
Okay, I heard a bad rumor that you've been practicing your losing face. That's sad.
No, it's not sad because afterwards I get to do whatever I want. No, it's fine. I really am just like totally happy to be here. I can't wait to use my losing face. Now if I win, I'm not going to be able to use it, so don't be sad.
Bradley, what was the color of Jennifer's Oscar dress? Very memorable dress.
Red.
That
was the hardest one yet. Let's just say that.
It was?
Don't you think? The no.
Really?
I don't think
so. How many pairs of Spanx was I wearing at the Oscars?
Bonus question.
Winner's Spanx.
On the set of Hunger Games, there was a cursing jar or something like that?
Yeah.
A swear
jar? That didn't go over well. That didn't last for very long. I mean, I think the kids are millionaires, but anytime you bring a swear jar on a set with a crew,
right.
it's just a cheap way to make $1 million, in my
right.
opinion.
Actually, on a regular, semi-regular basis, do you?
Cake balls.
Oh, those
Remember
are pretty
when you
good.
Made those cake balls?
I made those great cake balls.
Your cinematic crush.
Cinematic crush, oh, dead or alive?
Doesn't matter.
Doesn't matter? Well, no. Paul Newman.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, obviously.
Hello.
Yeah. Yeah, hello.
Tell me why, other than the obvious.
Well, it's probably just the obvious. I mean, he made really good movies. I love his sauce.
Yeah.
I love all of his dressings. I saw Cool Hand Luke when I was like 15 or something, and I was like, that's a man.
Do you think it's important to create a positive image for
women? Yeah, I think that this is where girls get their idea of what they're supposed to look like when they get all the media. And, you know, models can't do it because they get paid to be hangers.
I asked Bradley because, you know, there's all kinds of rumors going around that you guys are dating.
Oh, yes, we're in a relationship, yes, apparently.
We're in a massive, very serious relationship.
Heating up. Yeah. I can't tell you how many boyfriends I've had.
That's what happens when you get very popular.
Yeah, yeah.
And Bradley said,
"Impressed with somebody, and you have to spend more time with them."
If you weren't doing this, what would you be doing? What do you think?
I'd like to think. I always liked like medicine, and I'm pretty sure I think I can diagnose everybody. And so I would like to say doctor, but I know I don't have the focus for it. So I'd probably be like an out of work doctor, trying to illegally operate on people.
I hate shopping, and then I go in my closet and I hate everything that I'm putting on and everything in my closet, but I can't do anything about it because I hate shopping. So I'm in a fashion rut. Jennifer Lawrence has been in a fashion rut since birth. It's weird that I said my full name. It's just because you said, "How did Jennifer Lawrence?" Never mind. I'm just gonna refer to myself as Jennifer Lawrence this entire time. Jennifer Lawrence hates shopping.
Jennifer, you're very funny. That's very funny.
Thanks, Josh.